Hello, good morning. This is Dharam. Can you please tell me if you can hear me all right? You can see me all right? All right. I'm assuming that you can hear me and you can see me. Okay, great. So guys, thank you for joining the session. And this is the fourth session of PFMP test series. Especially we're talking about the questions you'd like to see in your PFMP exam, or similar question in your PFMP exam. Intentionally not to talk about which question you will see in exam, but how to deal with certain type of questions. So, by the way, my name is Dharam Singh, and I am your PFMP mentor today. And if you decide to pick me as your mentor, definitely I will help you with that. So I have been training PGMP since 2009, and PFMP we started teaching since 2013. And as of yesterday, one of my students, actually from Toronto, passed his PFMP exam with above target, or I say above target, and all the five domains as above target. So I will bring him to one of the podcasts to talk about his experience. But today is more about to get to familiarize you, make you familiarize with certain type of questions which you likely to see in your PFMP exam. And if you see them, how to deal with them. All right, so as I said, this is our fourth session. If you have not watched the previous, you were not in the previous webinar, please go through the YouTube links, which you probably have seen in the invites. If you don't have, let me know, I will organize that link to you. So we are going to talk about portfolio strategic management in this five questions we have. So if you have done the chapter, if you are have been reading this chapter, you will learn a lot. Even if you have not learned, you're a starter, you will still learn a lot out of that. Okay, so for record, the date today is 10th of September 2021. So let's get started. If somebody can write on the question pad, yes, you can hear me all right, that will be great. Okay, all right, maybe not. Or you can write on the chat, whatever works for you. All right, so this idea came some time back. Yes, my students are benefiting from my PFMP classes. And some of the questions, if I can share with the wider audience, will also benefit from this discussions. So yes, you're more than welcome to buy my PFMP Challenger or the computational guide. And when you're doing those questions, you like to know, hey, where can I find more information? And yes, if you want to join my mentoring program, you will learn from that. But if you want to, you know, some of the questions I'm discussing here, so you can come back to these discussions, okay? So about me, and we'll have a quick slide. You can see that, and how to pass your PFMP exam in your first attempt. I will introduce you to the YouTube link. I've actually put that link on the chat. If you're not seen, please see that, and session overview, and then we get into the questions. And then the last thing is, how can I be assistance to you? I can be a mentor, I can be a guide, whatever you feel like. So guys, thank you for joining. I'm very happy to see you here. And that means a lot to me. And I know same thing for you, that I'm good that we are here. So it is working really well. Lots of people have find this program really useful, and they are benefiting. So, and I like to acknowledge, and I have acknowledged this for last 1.5 or 2 years, we are still in the pandemic situation. A lot of places, the COVID is showing the impact. So, but the important thing is, if you have an opportunity to get vaccine, please get vaccinated. I was saying no to vaccine for a long, long time, but I realized it's not about me, it's about the community, it's about the country, it's about the planet Earth. So I have seen the results recently with one of my students' family. Actually, the younger one, he was not vaccinated. And he was the only person not vaccinated. He got COVID from school, and all others had vaccinated. The person and husband and the elder boy, they were Pfizer, and the wife is Moderna. So it doesn't matter. But the good news is all three, even though they were living together with this young 10-year-old boy, they didn't got impacted. So that's the testimony itself. But the younger one, the 10-year-old was hospitalized in the ER, and he's still there. I'm wishing him good health. But the good news is he has recovered, or he's recovering now. So I think that's the great news. The message here is vaccination is saving. Okay, so I have taken it, even though I'm into yoga and meditation. I strongly believe that I'm building immunity via that, but still I took the vaccine, and I think it is a good thing I did to myself and to my family and to society. All right, so this is about the what's going on. And all right, so somebody, I like to see some message on the question pad saying that yes, you can. Yeah, everything looks good, not good, thank you, whatever you want to say. But I like to see if you really can hear me, and you are able to, you know where to put the questions, because soon we're going to see your questions, and you have to answer the questions. So about myself, I have been in the teaching space, mentoring since 2009, rather, you know, a little bit early. I started with a few classes in PMP, but later on I got into PGMP. I've done the teaching for PG. I have been doing teaching, mentoring PGMP since 2009. I'm glad to say that it's now 345 PGMPs from 48 countries. I cannot be more happier than this. So last 6 years, I am contributing 50% on an average. I think, and I'm very happy with this. So it's a 10% of global PGMPs. So if anybody is interested in PGMP, or somebody or another colleague of you is looking for PGMP, please encourage them to talk to me. With PFMP, 72 PFMPs. So yesterday, one of my students from Canada, Toronto, he passed his exam. So he's a very smart guy. But when he came out and called me, Dharam, I passed the exam, I got above target, and his all five domains, he got above target. So, you know, whatever the best you can expect, he got it. But still, he said, Dharam, the exam was very, very difficult. Yes, the questions we discussed, class, we go through, lots of things were helpful to him, but he saw some new concept or something new, which, PMI picked up. That's good that he has some, the background knowledge and some discussion we had in the class helped him to go through this whole thing. So he was able to complete the exam, full exam, and still, and he went back to some of the question he marked for review, and he finished his exam, 3 minutes to go. So, but yeah, he was happy with that. So they said 72 PFMPs and 100% result so far, and above target results. So the pressure, not the pressure, but stress my student have is not that they're going to pass or fail. They don't want to be the first person to break my record. So if you do join my PFMP program, I know you will. It's not about the stress. It's about I will make sure you have everything to pass the exam. Rather, you get the result, our target result. You are happy and I'm happy. So I'm still looking. I want to see 100% at least with 100 first 100 PFMPs. I mean, going forward and always. I think it will be, it will stay at 100% for a long time. Yeah. All right. So I have been, I played active role with PMI Sydney chapter as a certification director, and then I was secretary of the chapter. So I learned a lot from that in that engagement of 3 years. And so far I've done many, many trainings around the world. Physical trainings. I used to travel before COVID, where there is a, Australia, I was there, India, and Saudi Arabia, UAE, Canada, US, Oman, Malaysia, Singapore, many, many countries. So yes, when the time is improved, I will be traveling, and hopefully we will meet one day face to face. And one other thing, if you're not noticed, I am into yoga for a long, long time, and I'm teaching yoga, Virtual yoga is happening Saturday evening, my evening time. So if you are interested to learn, keep learning from me, not only PGMP, PFMP, but about some life lessons, something, how can I manage my stress level? How can I improve my body function? So that's where you ask me, hey, Dharam, I'd like to be part of your PFMP, not PFMP, yoga class. And that's free, by the way. And I call my program as Yippie Yoga, Yoga in Park for Extreme Energy. Yes, and now we're not even happening in yoga in the park, but it's virtual, Zoom. So I call it Yippie Yoga Zoom. Okay. I'm giving free publicity to Zoom. Anyway, so how to prepare, how to pass for your PFMP exam in your first attempt, and hopefully with above target result. If you have not watched, I highly recommend you to watch this video. I have shared this link on the chat. If you're not seeing the chat, please go and chat, look at the chat, and you can copy the link, or you can write down the link and watch this. It's 1 hour and a little bit over, but I have gone through various things within this video, talk about eligibility part and how to get your application together, and many, many things you need to learn from this video. So please watch this one. You will like it. And I've love to see your comments. Am I adding value there or not adding value? So, you know, these are the things which encourage me to do more and more things. Hopefully I can do more and more free events like this so that, you know, people who cannot afford my program, they can still benefit from me. All right. So please, you know, if you get some successes for PFMP or something, if you're not attending the program, please mention the name somewhere in the corner. That's fine. Okay. So please watch this one. It's very, very useful. So about today's session, we will look at the questions, read the question carefully, read all the options carefully. Maybe you have to use some elimination techniques. Maybe you get the right answer immediately. So many times when you eliminate, even if you have no idea about the question, you have no idea about the topic, you don't want to leave it unattempted. One is there's no negative marking. And by elimination, you may be able to eliminate one, maybe possibly two. Then you have very good chance, 50-50 chance. Of course, if you have idea, where you know exactly, you have the answer. If not, you still pick one of them. All right, make a decision and keep going question after question. Take your time to answer. You know, of course, there is a limitation on time. You have only 4 hours, 170 questions, but I don't want you to rush the exam. So that will happen only when you have learned the techniques and you know how to get the answer, right answer in the shortest time. So most of my students, yes, yesterday, when he was doing the exam, yes, he was spending more time upfront rather than waiting, leaving for the later time. But I encourage my student to see all 170 questions. You have that, look, there are two targets. One is to see 170 questions, and second is, of course, you complete the exam and pass the exam. And why I'm saying seeing 170 questions, you really want to have a speed in such a way, you go to the exam, let's say you can plan 50 to 60 questions per hour. Yes, there will be hour when you are going slow because lengthy questions, but there will be hour where you can do more than 50 or 60 questions because one line or and you know the topic really well. Okay, so make the right choice. And also confirm that this is the right choice and this is what you want you to answer, because sometimes it happens to me. I want to pick B and accidentally I'm picking C. It's not that, you know, it's just the consciousness in the question. Anyway, so you can test out today. I have 5 questions for you. And I will encourage each of you to participate. Please participate. Even if you have no idea about the question, answer something. Because one is there's no negative marking. There's no judgment happening here. Because everybody is more focused on their learning rather than finding out who does not know what. So even if no idea, you get all 5 questions wrong, doesn't mean anything here. One is this is not an exam. And you have full opportunity to make mistakes. All right? So I like to see all of you participating. All right, let's get started. Question 1 is a very straightforward, simple question. And by the way, this is coming from portfolio strategic plan. So domain number one. So the key element of portfolio strategic plan is, while this is one liner, you know, you will be surprised that sometimes you get challenged. Mission, vision, benefits, objective. So please answer the question. Your time starts now. It's a one liner. You should get, if you know the top answer, you should be getting the answer almost immediately. Not yet, yeah, take your time. But I like to see all of you participating. The key element of portfolio strategy plan is mission, vision, benefits, objective. All right, keep going. I can see some questions, responses. Yeah. And you will be surprised that single line question, single line question can actually make you to realize that yes, there's a lot to learn here. Guys, please answer. Even though you get it wrong, doesn't matter. Yes, keep going. I need three more answers. Please. Keep going. Yeah, yeah, please, please, please. You still, I can allow you time, don't worry. Yeah, if you want to take more time, yes, take another few seconds, but I like to see your answer. So this is a very straightforward question, and unfortunately no one got it right. So look, you got stumped by this simple question. So first of all, we need to establish, we need to understand what is the strategic plan all about. Your portfolio strategic plan is based on organization strategic plan. So one of the key thing in a strategic plan is the vision. You talk about the future state, how it's going to look like. So the answer for this question is vision. Yes, all of them are important. Mission is important, benefit is important, objective important. But the question is the key element, the most important element of the portfolio strategic plan. Make sense? I like to see some feedback on the question pad. Are you getting this point? Does it make sense to you? I mean, I know we cannot talk here, but at least if you can make it interactive by you putting something, comments or something on the question pad, will help me to see if you are getting or not. All right, as I said, the question is straightforward. Once you know about the portfolio strategy plan, this question is a few second question. All right, couple of seconds. This question can, this kind of question can help you to speed up. All right. We already done that. Yeah, so that's what I say. No, I got a message here. I've not started the preparation, and that's perfectly okay. That's why if by coming here, you say, hey, I don't know this, but I'm going to take a step to learn. And this is going to create some curiosity in you. So as I said, may get wrong, all four, five questions wrong, doesn't mean anything here. And this is where you get encouraged to learn. Again, one liner. Organizational strategy is executed through program execution, ongoing operation, transition of program to operations, and the delivery of program and independent projects and ongoing operation activities. Again, it's a one liner question. You should be getting almost straight away. You should not take more than 2 seconds here. Okay, great. I can see some questions, responses almost within seconds. But please participate. Who have not answered so far, please participate. It will help you. Even if you get wrong, doesn't mean anything here. Okay, so far so good. I can see two answers, both correct so far. Can feel proud of. All right. Yes. Three out of three doubt, right, so far. Please continue. I'd like to see three more people sitting here and please participate. It's a very straightforward question, guys. Please answer something. I cannot be more encouraging than this. And remember, there is a discount code coming after this program, which can help you to benefit more from me. So I should actually have a reward to encourage everyone. Anyway, the question, the time up, and if you want to put answer, that's fine now even. So the question is very straightforward. We talk about organization strategy. how this organizational strategy is executed via program execution, ongoing operations, transition of the program to operation, actually all of them. If somebody says because of operation, not really. Because of the program, not really. It's a delivery of program and projects and ongoing operation activities. All of them are contributing to realizing the organization to realize their objectives, you know, value or a profit, margin, whatever you're saying, vision. So I can see all of you got right, whoever participated in this question. Thank you for participation. I'm really happy with that. So let's see. Answer is D, and yeah. Okay, good. Now, third question. It's a little bit more wordy. That's fine. Let's find it out. During solution discussion meeting of major portfolio component, senior level executive and program and project team members are invited. Based on past meeting observation, you noted that the team members hesitant to speak in the presence of senior executive. What is the best approach you take to get maximum output from everyone? Conduct a meeting as it is, focus group, Delphi technique, brainstorming. All right, your time starts now. So please go ahead and start answering the question. All right, keep going. Time is ticking. Okay. Somebody raising the hand. Do you want to say something? If you want to say something, please write on the pad. Actually, yes, this question is it's not only testing your knowledge as a portfolio manager. It's not testing your portfolio manager knowledge. It's more about how to facilitate the meetings. This case can be for project management, program management, even the portfolio management. So the knowledge of PEM book is useful. Many people, when they come back, especially not my student, they come and say, Dharam, I didn't pass the exam. The one of the thing I ask them, did you read the PEM book? And many times the answer is no. Because there's nobody is emphasizing that PEM book is really important. So if you see these three, B, C, D are coming from PEM book. You need to know all these terms. What is focus group means? What is Delphi technique means? Brainstorming. And you can do the Google. You'll find a lot of information. So the focus group is what? You have a particular topic or group, let's say HR team or marketing team, all of them have same focus. So you're talking. So that's a good way to get the best out of the common, with the people with the common knowledge. So the problem we have here in this particular scenario, there are people, they have a good knowledge, good, they want you to contribute, but because of some executives in the meeting, they are not able to contribute as much they want. So Delphi technique is the one which can help you to get the maximum out of all of them. Delphi is technique talks about anonymous feedback, maybe via questionnaires, maybe via having one-to-one sessions, and you collect that information and share with everyone. So in this kind of situation, Delphi technique will be useful. So if you got C, write, right. If you got B right or D, B or C, B or D, you got it wrong, that's okay. But now you need to learn about Delphi, brainstorming, and focus group. Okay. Yes, this was from PEM book. And PEM book is really, really important. I can tell you 15% questions are directly, indirectly coming from PMBOK. A lot of questions covering your earned value. If you remember earned value, if you are a PMP, you know what I'm talking about. You have to study earned value. You have to learn about NPV. You have to learn about IRR. You have to learn about cost benefit analysis. And many of these, you know, the purpose of portfolio manager is to pick the right project, right program, which will help your organization to achieve the objectives. And for that, you are analyzing them using various techniques, tools, using some Excel spreadsheets and calculation, bubble chart, whatever, to come up with your recommendation to the steering committee. All right. Okay, I'd love to know if I'm adding any value to you, please. All right, so, okay, yeah. Now, question number four. I have seen only three people participating so far. I'm looking for responses from other people as well. Guys, please participate. More you're going to participate, even if you get wrong, you have eagerness to learn. Okay, guys, please participate. Your portfolio team is running, portfolio team is planning to perform qualitative analysis for portfolio level risk, which are present in the risk register. Which tool do you suggest your team to use for this purpose? So you probably remember some tools, techniques from PMBOK as well. Even if you're not studying for PGM, PFMP, you should remember this kind of thing. Force field analysis, scenario analysis using Monte Carlo analysis. EVM, expert judgment. All right, your time starts now. All right, good. Okay, good. So far. Please participate. I'm feeling like I'm begging you guys to participate. Rather, you should be encouraged to say, Dharam, give me more questions. I'd like to be, want to do more questions. All right. Maybe somebody has issue. Okay. Never mind. So the time is almost up. All right. Any last minute taker? All right, no worries. Okay, so let's analyze the question. Answer is D in this case. The question is saying, we are talking qualitative analysis. If you remember from your, I don't know if you are a PMP or not, if you read the PMBOK or not, I'm assuming, I should not be assuming by the way. In PMBOK, PMBOK is talking about risk management. In risk management, we're talking about two types of analysis. One is qualitative risk analysis. Second is quantitative risk analysis. Okay. So qualitative is all about, getting the expert feedback. What that means is you talk to the, your SMEs, your team member to find out what they think about risk in this scenario, this situation, this phase. So they will be answering your question based on their past experience. Hey, Dharam, this is a possible risk. And this is high probability. The qualitative is kind of always, unless you talk about probability, impact, proximity, and talking about the priority. Yeah. And that can be analyzed only based on, and the priority can be analyzed based on probability and impact. So where do you get the probability? Yes, if you have a coin, you can use it either go to head or tail. So it's a 50% chance. If you have a dice, you can throw and you can have one in six chance to get one, any number. But if you're talking about having a bushfire in particular city in this summer, what's the probability? Yes, you go to look at the past history. The last 5 year, 10 year, 100 year, how many times we had a bushfire in this city? If you're talking about California, you can say, hey, Dharam, this is every year thing. So it's not a, this is not just a risk, it's actually very high risk. But if you're talking about having a bushfire in one of the Canadian country, a city, where you rarely see any this activity. But you say, oh, there's no bushfire. No, there's zero. But it can also happen that you may find that bushfire happening in, you know, in this, you know, British Columbia or something in that area. But anyway, so the risk is always based on your past, the knowledge, experience. That's why we're talking about expert judgment. EVM, you need to know what is EVM. EVM is expected earned value management. So there is a term EVM or EMV. EMV is expected monetary value. EVM is earned value management. So you need to know these acronyms as well for your exam purpose. Monte Carlo. Yes, you need to go and do the Monte Carlo simulation. So look into the, do a Google search or maybe go to Pembok. You will learn about that. Force field analysis, look at the force field analysis. All right, good. I hope you're learning something. All right. Okay, you can see that. Okay, so the last question. Please participate. The last question, you don't want to miss this one. This is not, I still don't say the list, very lengthy question. In exam, you might get a little more lengthy, but yeah, for this purpose, it should be enough. So you are managing information technology portfolio, IT portfolio. There are 10 project managers who are reporting to you. One of the project in your program has completed development effort and reached testing stage. The project manager decided to add one level of testing stage without compromising the project schedule and cost. What is your response? Advise project manager to raise a change request. Strictly inform the project manager to follow the schedule management plan, company schedule management plan. Escalate to governance board and analyze the consequence of adding new, adding the testing stage. Do nothing, project manager can decide to on this action with the level of authority. Okay, your time starts now. So this is last question, so please participate. All right, I can see some good answers. So even if you get wrong, I will have a discussion on that. So that will help you to learn. I know at least one or two people have not participated so far. It may be because they have some technical problems or something, but yeah, many people are, I think most of you are actively participating. So thank you for that. Okay, keep going. Still have time. All right. So this is an interesting question. So let's look into this. So one of the project in your program has completed development effort and reached to testing stage. So, you know, testing stage, and he or she has decided to add one extra testing stage and without compromising the project schedule and cost. So what is the response? So first of all, any change, any deviation from your approved strategy, approved plan is not acceptable. Reason is, yes, you may be doing good thing, but in case something wrong happened, who will be liable for this? The change request or change management is actually the way to control how we are running the project or program. In case you have audit in future, somebody can ask you, hey, why did you add this testing? Oh, because I had some team members sitting there doing nothing. I thought it's a good idea to utilize their effort. And it was not adding any cost and schedule impact. But I decided. Maybe it's a good idea. But what was the purpose of adding testing? Is it adding, you know, making the product even smoother or something else? So the raising the change request help you to get the right people into the change control board. Remember the change control board, we need to have right people to see the change from their point of view. So advise the project manager to raise a change request. So then follow the change control process. While there's no impact to schedule and cost, and that may be the result, the change control board may decide to continue, hey, don't worry, just continue with the testing. It's all good. It's actually adding more value. Customer will be more happy. Okay. So this way, you are getting the confidence. You are making sure that your project manager is informed, program manager informed, your steering committee knows what's happening. And in the end, when the results come out, you have tested, you have done the work as per your approved document, approved plans. Okay. So I hope I have added some value to you. So you can look into this. So as per my promise, I'm going to give you a discount code. If you find that discussion, my talking helping you to build this, we are on the same frequency. You think that I'm the one who can help you to achieve your PFMP, please contact me. I will give you a link where you can book a time with me to discuss more about your eligibility or anything about PFMP. So this is actually, I'm showing the current number. So I'm putting actually more than 10% PGMPs at the moment, and 72 PG, actually 345 as of now, and 72 PFMPs. And as I said, I'm maintaining 100% pass in a PFMP. I don't call 100% pass in PGMP. I have 86.6% at the moment. I'm happy with that, but I'm more happy with PFMP results. So good. So this is a link you like to use for booking some time with me. I love to spend time. If you have booked time with me, then you can discuss anything, about PGMP, PFMP, or anything else, or your career. But I will encourage you to utilize your time, or my time, as best as possible. So use this link. You can take a note and book some time with me. You can WhatsApp me. This is my WhatsApp number, as well as my phone number and my email address. And yeah. And you can reach out to me via LinkedIn, Facebook, or any other way. Anyway, so if you look at your chat, I have just shared with you a discount code. So when you're booking for any group mentor program or personal mentor program, or even the recorded mentor program, you can use this link, this particular coupon code. I'm not going to read out anybody who's watching this. You're more than welcome to contact me even later. But if you are already in the group, you can note down from the chat, and then you use the discount code when you're booking your class. And I have actually coming up with two PFMP program, one on 24th of September, and my time, I'm in US Pacific zone. That is 6 o'clock to 8 o'clock evening, my evening. So you have to check that your zone, time zone. And the next program will be on 4th October. 4th October time will be my morning. That's 9 to 11. So if you are in Middle East, you can calculate your time zone, or India, or in US. So you have option to join either program. So yeah, and if you want to have flexibility, you want to learn one-to-one, and the budget is not a problem, then definitely look for the personal mentoring program. Okay, so I like to see your feedback. If I am adding any value, it was worthwhile for you to spend 45 minutes here, or it was a waste of time. I like to know that as well. If I'm adding, because this is helping me to come back to you, encouraging me to, come to you and talk to you in this way. I do have one more session to is left in the series. I like to see your participation there. So please participate in that series. I think you will know the dates. I don't have calendar with me, but it will be in somewhere in October. So with this, I like to close today's session. Thank you for participating. Thank you for joining. And if you're not able to join, because I think there's somebody who is having technical problem, please reach out to me. And I'd love to talk to you and maybe help you with the way, whatever way you want to learn from me. So yeah, please note this. This link and book a time as soon as possible, because my calendar fill out very, very fast. All right, guys. So thank you for participating one more time, and hope to see your success very soon. And I will be very happy if I can be participating, or I can be part of your PFMP success for you. Thank you, and all the best to you guys. Take care. Bye now.